It doesn't matter if it's your first time here or you play here every week. A full house at Michigan Stadium always takes your breath away. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Michigan has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Brought down at the 33-yard line. Second and two coming up here. Ball on the 33-yard line. Nice run up the middle. Nice run there by the tailback, and it's good for the first.
I don't think there's a coach in the world who wouldn't be happy with getting 5 yards a carry.
He's tackled at the 48. From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. He's at the 40. And down he goes at the 31.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
From the 31-yard line, first down. Quick pass. Tackle around the 28-yard line. Slings it, and he's taken down at about the 15-yard line.
Nice job here by the quarterback of putting some air underneath this pass and letting his receiver catch up with it for a nice gain.
First and 10, ball on the 15. And now he pitches it. Tackle made at the 15-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. He's scrambling, and now the ball is loose. He picks it up, and he's level at the 11.
What was most impressive is how he followed the play, and he just didn't give up on it. It was that effort that allowed him to come away with the fumble.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 11-yard line.
Ready, red, come on!
And he just gets rid of it. Zips it to the back. They'll bring him down at the 12-yard line. Edwards only gains about a yard with that catch. Noel is the deep man awaiting the return. Booming kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Michigan's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Here he goes. Tries to get around the corner. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 40. He's on the run. And they make the stop at the 50.
Nice play, baby. Nice play. Hey, check Mike 34. Mike 34. Double.
That's a great tackle at the 44. So they gain 6 yards on the play and pick up the first down.
Heads-up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He gets to about the 24-yard line.
Tight right, tight right.
Tighten up. Pull together.
Check 24, check. Let's go.
Nice run, and he's brought down. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Third trip now into the red zone.
Ready. Check. Box two.
Get to that quickly. And he is drilled at the 5-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive. Touchdown, Cyclones. He hits the PAT. An 8-play, 78-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He might have a chance. And he hits him hard at the 35. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. And he tackles him hard at the 48-yard line. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. Iowa State's lead is a touchdown. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Second and 6. Ball on the 48.
Here we go.
388. Bumble. And the ball hawking safety scoops it out. Brought down at the 41. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball, and a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Iowa State is up a score. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Second and five. Ball on the 36. Makes it out to about the 20. And they were lucky that one didn't go for more.
They looked like they've never defended the option before. The tailback had a ton of running room there.
And he's hit immediately. Looking to go up two touchdowns. He scrambled. He's tackled at the one. They line up in the jumbo set. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. Fullback catches the pass for a touchdown.
I like that. Sneak your fullback out and get him the ball.
They really did confound the defenders with that fake. He splits the uprights with the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This defense has everything. They kind of have that blue-collar, workman-like approach, but they also have a blend of tremendous speed to go along with that work ethic. And the better they play, they seem to feed off of it, and it continues throughout the whole ballgame.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Caught by the sophomore. Inside the 30, the 10, and he's all the way in for the touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
Boy, that had to be a miscue of some kind or a mental error by the defense. This wide receiver was just too open for there not to be some kind of mistake by the defense. I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense on the sideline and to make sure everybody's on the same page.
And he adds the extra point. Like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns in two possessions.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Iowa State up 7 points. Has some daylight. Makes it to the 41.
Nice play, baby.
Third. decent run up the gut. They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Let's go! 5900!
Now he tries to buy some time. And down he goes around the 41-yard line. At about the 35. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space, and he dives forward. From the 27-yard line, first down. He's going to try and scramble. Slides down to the ground. Picks up about 7 yards on the scramble. This is the ninth play of this drive. The Cyclones taking their first time out of the half. Iowa State is up seven. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. They'll line it up again on third down. They got him for a loss, so they racked him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option.
Iowa State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It's up, and he's got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession has given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
First and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. And he's taken down at the 46. The Wolverines use their second timeout. Made right around the 26-yard line.
This secondary better tighten it up if they're going to slow down this drive.
Scrambling around. They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. So the scramble goes for 9 yards. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. The kick is up. And it splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Iowa State is up by a touchdown. Tackled after a decent pickup. We've played a half of football here. Iowa State's lead is a touchdown.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Both quarterbacks remaining upright and healthy. In fact, they haven't been breathed on in the first half. Neither team has allowed a sack, and it really speaks well for the relationship that the quarterback has and the feel that he has for his offensive line.
No, absolutely, and we always talk about those guys and going out to eat. Well, let me tell you something. They're earning a big, fat steak dinner, and those fat guys get the porterhouses too. They're not a cheap date. Those guys, they're earning it right now, keeping me up and right, keeping the quarterback upright, keeping him clean, you know, not letting anybody hit him. You've seen great Hall of Fame quarterbacks turn average when they get popped and when they get hit and when they get, you know, beat around a little bit. These guys, they haven't even been touched. So you can go ahead and say check, please, right over here, because that QB better be taking care of it.
And the quarterback's calling home, Mom, Dad, please send money. That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Rhys and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 28. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Out to around the 45. From the 45-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. Receiver. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He makes the PAT. A 5-play, 72-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
This game is all tied up, 17. He sends this one deep. Michigan is ready to kick it away. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Lets it fly, and it's incomplete.
He threw that ball so hard, I don't think anybody wanted to catch it.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. And he shoved out of bounds at the 37-yard line. He has some room. He's at midfield. And they make the stop right around the 48-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Crunch time, defense.
Here we go. Line 50.
He's on the run. And he's going to be sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
He's knocked out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Quick pass. He's taken down around the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, first down.
Focus, defense, focus.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. This is the eighth play of this drive. Pitches back. Nice run to the outside.
He ain't going nowhere.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Three down.
Touchdown, Cyclones.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
And he hits the PAT. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 24-17. Michigan's licking on offense right now, Kirk. A whole different story from the first half.
Yeah, I think they've made a few tweaks to their game plan, and I think it's helped them out. The quarterback seems to be making better decisions. Right now, they can't be stopped.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. And he's tackled around the 29-yard line. It's second and six. Ball on the 29.
Ready?
Brought down at the 26.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. The blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
Larry. Mike check 33. Watch the pass.
He's tackled around the 40-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 40.
Ready.
Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Fights forward to about the 46. They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Larry. Hey, check 33. Check
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Now he's scrambling. Room around the corner. Diving for extra yardage. Here he goes. And he tackles him hard at the 39. Quarter to go, and this looks like it could come down to the very end. The Cyclones with a touchdown lead. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Three down.
Come on, you 1-8.
Mike, ready?
33.
White, 80.
Motion.
And that one's incomplete. Just flung it out there, and it was short.
He got a little bit lazy here. There's no question. He should be able to make that throw 9 out of 10 times. That was the one time he missed it.
So they're going to go for it here. He tries to buy some time. And down he goes around the 20-yard line. It's the 11th play of the drive. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Too easy.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 16. He's scrambling. The 10 dives for extra yardage. And this is the 13th play of this drive. Michigan. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. It's on the ground. It's recovered. Great play by the defender to pick up that ball for the recovery.
It was a clutch play as well. Now their team has all the momentum. When you're a quarterback and you start this close to the end zone, your eyes just light up when you take the field. Conversely, the defense is thinking, uh-oh, we can't let them get another one so quickly.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep, those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
Hand off, and he's met in the backfield. from their own 21-yard line. Third down. Zips it to the back. Tackle at the 32. Morris is back awaiting the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 19-yard line. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. For a sack on the play.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
And that'll be three and out. Noel will be the return man. Booming kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Stepping up. And he is drilled at the 30. He's going to try and scramble, and they get the sack. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Just under 2 minutes in the game. The corner, and he's taken down at the 39-yard line. Throws this one out to the right. Tackle made at the 30-yard line. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Fires out to his wideout, and he hits him hard at the 7-yard line. First and goal, fourth quarter, all tied up. What's it going to be? Picked up a yard, if anything, on that run. Iowa State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 7-play, 81-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The score now, 31-24. They're lined up to kick, and they might just kick it short and prevent a long return. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. Tosses across the middle to his tight end. They'll bring him down at the 44. From the 44-yard line, first down. Tries to fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted. And he's level at the 47. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He'll go down to one knee. The Wolverines are going to call their second timeout. Iowa State is up by a touchdown. He takes a knee. The Wolverines using their third and last timeout. Takes a knee. And the ball game's over. The Cyclones get the victory, 31-24. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.